A very pleasant evening to all the jury members and all the co-presenters present today. My name is Siddhi Chaurasia, and being a third year undergraduate, it is my preliminary effort to present to you all my paper on the topic Forensic Frauds, a Review, which basically deals with digital imaging fraudulence in forensic odontology. Next slide, please. In today's era of forensic investigations, hard copies of forensic data have been replaced by digital records. Wide availability of image processing softwares makes digital image manipulation an easy and low-cost way to distort or conceal facts. My review presentation attempts to focus and understand the fraudulence in the digital records in forensic odontology and various ways to detect as well as to prevent it to an appreciable extent. Next slide. So let us begin with short description of the ways in which a digital image can be manipulated. The first one is image retouching. This is the least harmful method of image manipulation. The only aim of image retouching is to make the subject in the image more attractive and thus is the most common method of image manipulation. Image retouching does not lead to loss of any details of the image but may lead to enhancement of certain features whereas diminution of others in the original image. Next slide, please. The second method of digital imaging fraudulence is image splicing or photomontage. This method refers to a paste-up produced by sticking together images using digital tools available such as Photoshop, image splicing technique, which involves composition of two or more images which are combined to create a fake image. We can understand this better with the help of day-to-day example. Like in the photos, we see that how two fruits, lemon and kiwi, have been combined to produce one single fruit in the image shown. Next slide. The third method is copy move attack. In this technique, one covers a part of the image to add or remove information. A part of the same image is copied and pasted into another part of that image itself. In a copy move attack, the intention is to hide or add something in the original image using some other part of the same image. Moving on to the next slide. Now, what are the methods to detect the fraudulence in digital imaging? The methods include JPJ, double quantization effect, error level analysis, copy move forgery detection, and inconsistent image quality. Next slide, please. Now, what are the methods to prevent the fraudulence in digital imaging? The first one is digital watermarking. So the purpose of a watermark is to recognize the work and discourage its unauthorized usage. The second method is metadata. Can you please move to the previous slide? Yeah. So the second method is metadata. Metadata involves attaching information in the form of data to a digital image. So parameters such as dimensions, width, height, horizontal and vertical, all these parameters remain unchanged. So any manipulation to the digital image will change all these parameters and it can easily be detected then. Next slide, please. Therefore, I would now like to conclude my presentation by saying that the very nature of digital imaging makes it very easy for the operator to adjust or modify digital image files. As a consequence, the modification of images for malicious purposes is now common than ever. Anticipatory measures should be taken to avert their malicious use. Until there is an integrated response from the research community as to how this subject of great concern can be dealt with more efficiency. Otherwise, the problem of data beautification will continue to plague science. Next slide. These are my references. And next slide, please. Thank you.